ONI originally was going to be stop motion. In the end, I think just the breadth of the work, and it kind of became untenable to do it in stop motion. It would have taken forever. And so we ended up doing it full CG.
So we had over 2,000 shots to do with pretty small team in Japan. The biggest challenge was really to get that amount of work done in a place where we didn't even have an asset workflow yet. And as we were making the asset workflow, we felt like, wow, that's the right timing to get into Solaris. That was about 2 years and a half ago. The show was originally made to be a stop motion show. So the idea in the director's mind was this very realistic puppet that you can actually touch. So the look of ONI came out of not necessarily trying to absolutely make it look like puppets, but definitely makes it feel real. Solaris came at a perfect time, basically, where it was slightly early, it was not perfect yet, but we felt like this has a huge potential. We have to create this multi-shot workflow to be able to handle all of these shots. And Houdini is what we know the best. We talk with side effects. Can we get some help? Can we actually like try to work together on, you know, making sure that the things that might not be stable yet just work fine? Honestly, in the end, things worked pretty smoothly, even though it was a quite early version. So, you know, I think we made the right choice.
In the last episode of ONI, there's a lot of fire. Since the lighting is very natural in the show, it was important that the fire is the main light source. What really helped us was building a library of fires, and then we could use them in Solaris, do the instancing there. We can adjust it per shot if we need, and then have lights instanced there as well that are the main light source of the show. And so we had 165 shots with fire. And so we started with doing an initial layout of the scene, and then we just push out all the shots. And then we can see how it behaves and then do tweaks on each shot to make sure that we have like a nice lighting and like nice composition. That really helped us because on one point it was very fast to push everything out. And then on the other hand, we still had the control to make it look as nice as we can.
You know, it didn't take a lot of people to do this project, which is really, it's surprising. I mean, the number of shots that we had over 2,000 shots. We had over 2,000 assets. When you look in the credits, I think you'll see two lighters listed. You'll see a team of maybe 10 asset artists. I mean, if you think of the like shots per artist, even the compositing team, you know, maybe 10, 12 people doing so many shots. You really, really need to create a pipeline that works and that relies on having good software. So, you know, for us, you know, rigging, modeling, animation was done in Maya, but, you know, the core of the workflow was done in Houdini. And, you know, being able to build scenes where somebody can render, you know, click a button to render 90 shots, you know, overnight, just really made it possible to do a project like that.